Come Sunday, daylight savings is about to wreak havoc on children's sleeping patterns. But one Adelaide specialist says there are simple solutions to ensure bedtime doesn't change with the clocks.
Children's bedtime can be a challenge, but it's even more difficult when the sun's still up.
Is it certainly a lot harder to get them to sleep when they can still see things that are in the rooms?
Winding the clock forward an hour can throw even the strictest of routines into chaos. And the loss of sleep can have even more serious consequences than just grumpy children.
Significant impacts upon daytime behaviour, appetite decreases, the speed of learning goes down. For the parents, for the carers, they become much more high maintenance.
Dr. Simons experiences an influx of overwrought parents at the start of daylight savings each year. He says the best approach is to ease children into the new sleeping pattern.
Sometimes it's a little difficult to make a jump for a whole hour, and so making a 15-minute or a 20-minute adjustment each night for three consecutive nights will do the trick.
Parents should resist soothing their toddlers or babies before 6 a.m.
If you make contact at 5 a.m, you're in trouble.
Darkening the room as much as possible can also help. But his biggest tip, go by the clock, not the sun.
Have confidence that you will succeed quite quickly. Mother's the boss, the child is the child.
On top of daylight savings next week, back to school means back to bed early. Easier said than done after later nights during the holidays.
Donna's children now take just a few days to adjust to their new schedule.
The same bedtime routine, and that way they still know that they've had their dinner, their bath, and they're brushing their teeth, so that helps.
Making bedtime no longer a nightmare. Alice Monfries, 10 News.